In this video, I will show you how to simulate gateway cloning with multiple inserts in SnapGene. Check out our other tutorial to learn how to simulate gateway cloning with a single insert. To perform gateway cloning with multiple inserts, go to Actions and Gateway Cloning. SnapGene can simulate the BP and LR reactions with up to 4 fragments. For this example, I will select the 3 fragments option. Begin by uploading your first ATB fragment file, if it is not already open. To do this, use the drop-down menu to the right. Next, select the sequence of interest by choosing a feature on the map view, or switch into the sequence view to choose a specific sequence. Then switch to the next ATB fragment slot by pressing the number 2 button. As before, upload your file, and select your desired feature or sequence. Finally, repeat the process for any remaining fragment slots if you have them. As before, upload the file and select the sequence. With the ATB fragments now defined, switch to the Donor Vectors tab. For each ATB fragment, you need to specify a suitable donor vector. You can use the drop-down menu to select a custom donor vector file if you have one. Alternatively, choose from SnapGene's list of commercially available donor vectors. SnapGene will automatically highlight the most suitable donor vector for that specific ATB fragment in the list. In this case, SnapGene recommends the pDonor221P1-P4 vector for fragment 1. To confirm this selection, click on the file name in the list. Now switch to the second donor vector slot and select a suitable donor vector again. And if you have any remaining donor vector slots, be sure to repeat the same process. With all donor vectors selected, switch to the Destination Vector tab. For the Destination Vector, you can use a custom file by using the drop-down menu, or you can select an option from the list of standard vectors underneath. With all the sequences now specified for the gateway cloning reaction, switch to the Expression Clone tab and select Choose ATB PCR Primers to set the ATB primer settings. In the new window, set the orientation of each insert and the desired target melting temperature for the PCR primers. Once you're happy with the settings, click Choose Primers to design primers to add appropriate ATB sites to the ends of each PCR product. You can preview the final product in the Expression Clone tab. Switch to Sequence View to assess the fusion boundaries and ATB primer sequences. Additionally, the schematic presents an overview of the sites on each fragment at the bottom. Under the Entry Clones tab, you can also preview the individual entry clones. You can use the numbered buttons to toggle between the clones. And if you'd like to create a new file for an entry clone, tick this option here. Finally, to create the expression clone file, give it a suitable name in the dialog box and click Clone. You can switch to Primers view in the new product file to see all the ATB primer sequences. Or go to History view to see the steps performed in your gateway cloning simulation. For more SnapGene tutorials, visit snapgene.com.